Well, good morning to you all. Just going to do a quick video. I haven't shot one for a few weeks. It's probably been a month. Just thought I'd show you some of the stuff that I bought over the years that I haven't done anything with that I've been meaning to. The first one I'm going to show you here is this Q1. This was a wartime light game designed by Boyd. Those distinctive wheels on there. Anyway, this is a kit built, so she's made out of it's white metal. And I didn't build it, I bought it. It was cheap and I didn't have one, but fortunately it's missing a bit of detail there on the front with the valve gear there. But I might be able to do something about that in the future. Always meant to, redo this model, but I just haven't got around to it. But I was just interested with the kit making back in the day was quite prolific. People building their own Legos. It's probably the same today. It's just not something I've ever really got into. I don't know if this has sprung rudders or the other. Yeah, it does. Wowee. Even got sprung buffers, so it's got some detail about it. And not the most attractive paint job, but these probably weren't the most attractive locomotives either. But it was a bit of fun. But it goes well. Anyway, I've just got something else to show you. There we go. This is a J50, and it's also a kit. Now I've got to assume that these are both Kitmaster, given that they're English models. This one's not too bad condition. Cosmetically it's okay. The person that had it's done a reasonable job building it. It also has a sprung buffer, so a bit fancy. There's the underneath. This is a very low geared model too, so it's not fast in any means. Those pickups though, if you can see them, it's the ones with the they're spring loaded to come into contact with the wheels, but as the springs wear out they get very unreliable. So I'd like to change them actually, but it's going to take a bit of a fiddle. And I bought this one because I only really had this one, which is the LNER, which is a nice model, but it is a bit toy-like. Connecting rod there doesn't attach to the middle wheel, but at least LNER did the right thing with the wheel arrangement there. I mean, that is pretty correct in comparison with the kit built one. You can see that the front two wheels are a lot closer as opposed to the standard trying the six chassis that they use for all models, without taking into consideration the wheel arrangements. But LNER did a nice job on this for what it was. It's a nice paint job. It's good enough. But when I realised that it's just a floating wheel, it doesn't do anything. Makes it more of a toy, doesn't it? But still runs well, and so does this one. I'll put it up and I'll give it a run and show you. Okay, here she is. She's up on the on the line. I'll see if she's going to move. Sometimes it needs a tap of encouragement. For just whatever reason. There we go. Didn't have it down on the line properly. Very, very good runner. Very good motor in it too. You could probably even put a flywheel on it and it could run even better. But, yeah, that was about as, that was full speed what you just saw, so this is probably a more realistic speed. This thing would pull probably my entire rail collection, it's so heavy. My entire carriage collections. Not too sure how many carriages these would have moved around in the day. They look quite powerful. It's a nice model for a kit build. It's got a few missing features on it, but there's some steps missing. I'll replace those down the track when I can be bothered to make some. But still, runs nice and quiet. Very smooth. The only thing I've done to this is put a coal load in. And I've got it sagging in the middle to make it look like the coal's starting to go down. It's so boring when you look at coal loads that they're just flat straight across the top. And as you can see, there's a bit of detail there. The valves and the whistle. Nice big steam dome there in the middle. They've even got the water caps there. Very nice. Come around to the front. There's the rail around the top of the boiler there. Handrail there on the other side. The handrail hanging off the sides of the middle of the LACO itself. Not much going on in there. But a nice enough logo. Anywho, this is just a little catch up. I'm just being curious to know if anyone's ever built these Kitmaster. Well, I'm assuming this is a Kitmaster logos. Yeah. Just think that in their day they would have served the purpose. Anywho, I'll catch you again soon. Take it easy.